Good morning, you're watching PA Harness Week. I'm Sharla McBride. August has finally arrived, and that means the weather is getting hot, but the action on the track is even hotter. We have a great show for you on hand. We're going to start off at the Poconos, but we've got races from the Meadowlands and right here at Harrah, Philadelphia. Take a look at what you can expect to see in this next half hour.
Fire off in pacing.
Mick Wicked gets back on track at Harrah, Philadelphia. We'll show you how he did. Plus, the Hamiltonian picture gets a bit clearer. Will the filly Mission Brief get her shot against the boys? Also, we'll take a trip to Western PA and the Meadows for the Adios Olives. And I'll tell you the story about a very talented young female driver from the land down under. Racing's fastest paced half hour starts right now on Comcast Sportsnet.
They're off.
Hi there, Kim Asabi, and welcome to Harrah, Philadelphia for another exciting adventure of PA Harness Week. She's Heather Vitale, I'm Steve Ross, and we are all psyched up. We're geared up. We're getting ready for the big event. It's coming up at the Downs at Mohegan Sun Pocono. When? An exciting week, August 15th through the 22nd. Be there or be square. Believe me, if you're a harness racing fan, you will be there. It's just that easy, right?
Like, it's festivities all week long. On August 15th, they're going to have the Clydesdales out there. And then August 18th and 19th, they're going to be rolling back the prices for a lot of concessions. Because, by the way, they're celebrating 50 years.
Right.
I mean, that's, like, why this is such a gigantic celebration. Oh, my goodness, the 21st, a Legends race, Motown concert, 22nd, Pete Rose. Now, that's a big night.
Yes.
22nd. Pete Rose is going to be there. Not Pete Tulip. You know, not
really?
Pete Dandelion.
Not Pete Moss? No?
Pete Rose is going to be signing autographs that night. That's incredible, right? And it is.
He's been on some horses in his past, I think. I may be wrong, but I think he has.
Super Stakes Saturday also. For me, that's a little even bigger than Pete Rose being there.
Oh.
Super Stakes Saturday.
Yep.
That is the Battle of the Brandywine. The Valley Forge, Colonial Trot, like a huge night. Over $2 million in purses that evening.
And you guys are going to want to be out there. It's a one-week celebration, August 15th through the 22nd. And you know, it's a great story about Pocono. They went from the outhouse to the penthouse, literally, to become one of America's premier racetracks. Right, Heather?
Oh, absolutely. I mean... The track is so lightning fast. Like, if horses want to take records, and it's a 5/8, it's not even a mile.
No.
Horses want to take records, very often they go to Pocono to do so.
Absolutely. And speaking of Pocono, let's go to Saturday's ninth race, and Heather's got it for you.
I do. All right, non-winners at 18,000. Last five, the purse is $20,000. Number nine is Captive Audience. He's the favorite. Andrew McCarthy is down on this one and two other ones, but he chose Captive Audience. Number three is Some Size, Some Style. Going up in class, but he's getting a lot of respect on the tote board because he's coming off a really big effort.
It's a count rollover on the drop tonight from second, Some Size, Some Style makes a move for Joe Pavia Jr. and takes the lead away. A count rollover back in the pocket. It's a hot pace here. Sterling Cooper in from Yonkers third, followed by Specialty Rocks and then Captive Audience. Off the impressive win last time is Even Money, and he's headed out there from McCarthy and going to get cover from Specialty Rocks. Verdad joins the outer flow, as does Aslan seventh. Then back the inside, Haircraft and Mickey Hanover. Half mile reach, 54 and 2. 28 and 3, second panel. Up top, it's Some Size, Some Style by about a length and a quarter, trying to gain separation from a count rollover. Specialty Rocks first over, but at the moment stalled a bit, three lengths back. Inside, Sterling Cooper slides up, and now three wide. There goes Captive Audience, not going to wait around for that cover. He's within three of the lead and gaining. Also far outside, Verdad, then Haircraft and Aslan, but it's still a lead for Some Size, Some Style, three quarters, 121 and 3, 27 and 1 third panel. Some Size, Some Style now dealing with Captive Audience in full gear on the outside. Back at the pylons, account rollover, Sterling Cooper coming up fourth. Top of the stretch, Some Size, Some Style, Captive Audience just about even now. It's Captive Audience, Some Size, Some Style not giving in easy here. Captive Audience, slight lead.
Account rollover set off the first teletimer in 25 and 4 before Some Size, Some Style took over. He looked really good rolling past the three-quarter pole and 121-3, but he could not hold off Captive Audience, who rolls by him to win in 149-3. Oh, that was like a walk in the park for Captive Audience because he was just coming off a 148-4 mile. Oh. Okay, so like whatever, sub Juman or sub 150. Oh my gosh, I almost said sub 2 minute. I'm Ooh, so old school.
You are old school, big time, right?
Sub 150, sub 150. Okay, Andrew McCarthy, winning driver for trainer Doug Berkeley. Second was Some Size, Some Style, and third went to Bear Dad.
So the moral of the story is Andrew McCarthy had his choice of three, and he picked the right one.
Yes, he did.
Way to go, Andy. You the man. Yeah, right. Good stuff. Stick around when we come back. More action aplenty from Pocono. Don't go away.
On top, Ontario success. Returning from the Meadowlands, Anthony Napolitano in the bike.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do. The places you see. The people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things. The incredible things. And the spectacular things. That makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of Life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
Hey there, you. Welcome back to PA Harness Week. We're at the old Harris Philadelphia Corral. And more racing action to take place. Saturday's tent was at Pocono. It was a condition-based non-winners at $22,500 in their last five starts. High-class horse flesh. 24 dimes on the line. Number three, Sparky Mark with Simon Alar was even money. Number five, Ontario Success was 5-2 with Ant Knapp. Number six, Blatantly Best with Joe Pavey Jr. was 4-1. And here's Jim Revilla.
On top, Ontario success. Returning from the Meadowlands, Anthony Napolitano in the bike. Pocket seat for Sparky Mark. A winner last time in this same group. He's at even money for Simon Allard. Another length and a half back there to Reuben Brogdon in from Yonkers third. Nobody attacking the leader, so the pace has slowed down nicely here, at least nicely for the leader, Ontario success. Blatantly Best comes out now, first over around the turn, followed by To Beach His Own on the inside of the back, Malaku's Wad and Mustang Art. Half mile 55-3, 29 in 1 second panel. Anthony Napolitano had it his own way on the front stretch, but now off stride goes Ontario success, and he's having a hard time getting out of everybody's way. Now Sparky Mark able to get by on the inside. Rough go of it for Pavia there. Had to swing Blatantly Best out wide. Now from far back coming up on the outside, Reuben Brogdon into third, followed there by To Beach His Own and Malak Uswad. Sparky Mark inherited the lead at three quarters, 123 even, 27 2/3 panel. Sparky Mark now leads by a length. Reuben Brogdon trying to reel him in. Inside still right there. Pavia with Blatantly Best further back to Beach His Own. Top of the stretch. Sparky Mark by about a length. Blatantly Best trying to close.
Ontario success left hard, grabbed the front and set the pace for half before jumping off stride to the collective sound of "Oh no" from the Pocono faithful. Sparky Mark, who sat the tool hole and herded the lead despite getting interfered with, and won it by two in 150 flat. Blatantly Best was second. Number three, Reuben Brogdon, off at 9-1 with Howard Parker, got third. We ain't done, not by a long shot, folks. When we come back, action aplenty from Harris Philly, and we will meet the brightest driver on the Australian harness racing scene. Don't go away.
It's showtime. It's all about the action, the odds, the wagers. It's all about who drives who. It's all you need to be part of the action. PA Harness Week, harness racing's fastest paced half hour. Saturdays, 10:30 a.m. on Comcast Sportsnet Philadelphia. Online at harnessweek.com.
Hello there, harness racing fan, and welcome back to PA Harness Week. She's Heather, I'm Steve. We mentioned before the break about the brightest star on the harness racing scene in Australia. Her name is Brittany Graham, and the lovely Heather's going to tell you all about this newcomer.
Oh my gosh, Brittany, I really bonded with her over the past month. She happened to come over to America, and we spent a lot of time together. And
did you go to Outback, perhaps?
To where?
Outback. the restaurant. Come on. What's wrong with you, dude?
Come on, mate. Well, you know what? Brittany does not wrestle crocodiles, but I can tell you she probably could. She's talented and just so sharp. Sharla.
She's got guns?
Oh, yeah, and she's strong. Ooh. Yeah, she could do anything. But Sharla McBride caught up with Brittany, and we're going to find out more.
From the land down under to the land of the free and home of the brave, Brittany Graham has taken her talents to the Western Hemisphere this month. As a winner of the Centenary Classic Mercedes-Benz Young Achievers Award, Graham is spending 1 month racing here in North America.
I was lucky enough to win the girl division, and Trent Moffat won the male division, so it was a month's stay over here. And we've had a brilliant time.
At 19 years young, Graham leads a busy life. She trains and drives horses in Australia, and she's also a full-time college student.
My dad, Daryl Graham, he has a big team at home, so I'm lucky enough to get some really good drives from him, and I have two of my own that I train in Australia as well, but I also study full-time at university, so it's busy life.
Here in America, Graham is getting the experience of a lifetime and learning from some of the sport's biggest names.
We were lucky enough to stay with Ross Krogan, so he's been having us at his place, and we've been at his stables a fair bit, so that's been great. And he also organised for us to go to a few of the other major stables, so we were lucky enough to go to Tony Alanya's barn and work with some really nice horses there, and also to Ron Burke's barn, so we got to drive some very nice horses there. I was lucky enough to jog forward again, so that's something that I'll definitely never forget. And we also went to Jimmy Tactor's property, so that was definitely an eye-opening experience.
Graham is enjoying every second of her visit and plans to continue her harness racing success when she returns to Australia.
Yeah, it's definitely something I want to do for the rest of my life. I know I'm going to uni at the moment, but I'm sort of classing that as a bit of something that I can fall back on if need be, but hopefully if I can continue to have success in the sport, I'll be able to make a living out of it.
Reporting for PA Harness Week, I'm Sharla McBride.
It was fun. It was good. We went very fast, know that. It felt fast anyway.
Wow, she is all you said and more.
Oh yeah, all that and a bag of chips. Or whatever they eat in Australia. Yeah.
Whatever it is, mate, she's got it, you know?
Yeah, she's absolutely
good
incredible.
Stuff. Best of luck to you in the future in this game. It's going to be fun watching the career of this lovely lady, Brittany Graham. Yes, indeed. Time for more harness racing action now. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to Thursday's second. It was a Pennsylvania Sire Stakes race, and Heather's got that for you.
Yes, I do. Now, these took place at Harrah, Philadelphia. There's five divisions. They're going for just over $52,000. Number five is Dupree, led the way around the Harrah's Philly Oval, but it was number three, Truemass Volo, with Tim Tetrick in the bike, benefiting from a guard spot journey, winning in 157-4 with a pocket journey, and it was a Doug Hamilton trainee breaks his maiden with this win and pays 26.40. The four, Lagerfeld, who is a favorite, was first up, and he took second. Dupree picked up third.
Thursday's fifth was another Pennsylvania Sire Stakes race here at Harrah's Philly. Number two, Hit It Out of the Park with Corey Callahan, was the even money chalk, but it was number five, Alexander Hanover, the 5-2 third choice, who won this heat, getting a perfect two-hole trip behind the pace setter. Number seven, Earn and Burn, the 8-5 second choice of Yannick Jingra, finished second. Hit It Out of the Park got third.
Okay, now on to the third division. While the seven, Sliding Home, and the four, Sutton, had a little battle on the front. It was number eight, Love Matters. He was just loving his second over trip. Driver Marcus Miller drives Love Matters to a 159 victory, and this horse is trained by Marcus's dad, Irv Miller. He pays 21.20. Sutton was second, and third went to Amectino.
Okay, next up, Thursday's 11th, number five, Cufflink Hanover, with Dave Miller, was odds on at 3-5, but was never really in this heat. Number six, Make or Miss, off at 5-1 with Yannick Jingra, wired in 156-2. Number two, Milligan School, 5-2 with Andy Miller, was a neck back in second. Number three, Iron Mind Becky, a 40-1 bomber with George Dennis, got third.
Okay, now it's the fifth in the final division, and you know what? They saved the best for last. Well, the best payoff anyway. If you bet number six, Sweet Tooth Hanover, with David Miller in the bike, you had one yummy-tastic ticket in your hand. The Randy Bendis trainee, okay, with a pocket trip, pays 55.20. He scored in 158-1, the big time favorite, number 7 State, staying focused. And number 5 Landjack Hanover put up a good fight on the front, but they had to settle for 2nd and for 3rd.
All right, okay. Sunday's 5th and feature here at Harris Philly, the $30,000 open pace, number 4. Great Vintage, you may recall, won the inaugural racing of the Jerry Taylor. You know, I still do that. I trip over my tongue when I was going to say the inaugural running, but harness racing people for a long time said you couldn't say run when you associated that with pace or trot.
Oh.
They would get all lagged. They'd get all, their underwear would get all in a knot.
Right. Yeah, I wonder what that I felt back there.
Yes, okay. Thank you. Okay. Okay. 3-5 on Great Vintage with Scott here on number 5, Caution Signs with Corey Callahan was 3-1. Number 7, Mick Wicked. You'll remember him. Last year's 3-year-old pacing champion was 5-1 with Dave Miller and with a call, Mike Bozich.
Up the bank stretch to go, rating Great Vintage leads it by a length and a half. The pace will pick up now. Caution Signs continues with Pocket Presence. Dream Out Loud trying to continue first over. Towards the inside with no place to go is All-Star Legend. Second over, El Bloom Beef, though. McWicked commits to the outer flow. 5 to come for that one. Bandolito is 7th. And Ideal Matters trails the field around the turn. 3/4, 1:22-1 for Great Vintage, who looks to get away. Dream Out Loud continues the grind on the outside. Caution Sign sitting a looser pocket. Elbloom beat those 3 wide. McWicked about to come 4 wide as they straighten away. But it's Great Vintage looking to get away. Leads it by 3 lengths. Dream Out Loud on the outside. Caution Sign's up the inside. McWicked's closing wide as the ball with Ideal Matters further out. They come down to the finish. Great Vintage meant business today.
Great Vintage grabbed the top and bid bye-bye to win by 2 in 151. McWicked was just chilling back before Dave Miller let him pace some, and he got 2nd. Number 2, Dream Out Loud, 14-1 with Andy Miller, picked up the show dough. And stick around when we come back. We're going up to Vernon Downs to see a couple of Zweig Memorials. Good stuff coming up and much more that we can't tell you about right now because we don't want to write just yet. We'll be back.
Life. It all comes down to the things you do, the places you see, the people you meet. It's all of the beautiful things, the incredible things, and the spectacular things that makes us feel unexplainable things. Life is going on. All you have to do is choose to live it. Full of Life, Mohegan Sun Pocono.
There and welcome back to PA Harness Week. We're here at Harris, Philadelphia. She's Heather Vitale. I'm Steve Ross, and we're now going to Vernon Downs, a heavily anticipated event each and every year. It is the Zweig Memorial. But how do you say it?
Zweig.
You say Zweig, I say Zweig. You say tomato, I say tomato.
You how say, do you know I said tomato?
You say potato, I say potato.
Oh my gosh!
Well, what is it? Is it Zweig or is, what do you say?
Zweig.
Zweig. Can we just go Zweig? It's time for the Zweig Memorial. Yes, here's the Zweig Memorial. And the first Zweig Memorial will be covered by Heather Vitale.
I have the division for the
you
three.
You got the
Zweig? I have the division for the 3-year-old trotting fillies. The purse is $185,000. There's a trio of ladies in here, and they're starting for the Ron Burke stable. Of course, in this 3-horse entry, they're the favorite because we've got the trotting phenom, 1A, and that's Mission Brief. So I just got to give you the lowdown on her. She's known as a super freak because she's got this eye-popping, you know, fast talent. She's unbelievable. She was last year's 2-year-old trotting sensation, you know. So this year, she starts off the year 2 victories, but not really crazy fast. You know, she wasn't as impressive as the year before. They add the trotting hobbles. She finishes 2nd. A very, very good effort. First
time
with
the best in that race,
yeah, with the trotting hobbles. Mm-hmm. This is 2nd time trotting hobbles, so let's see how she does.
Campbell has Wild Honey up front here by a length and a half. Wild Honey leads it. Entry mate is Magic Marker in the 2nd spot. Mission Brief looks to be an anxious 3rd, moving off the turn and down the backstretch. So it's She Glides trotting in 4th as Jingra moves. Mission Brief to the outside from 3rd, 2nd, and she comes on to challenge for the lead. Sweet Thing is trotting 5th near the half mile. Gap of 2 lengths to Concentration. And then it's another length to Gatka Hanover. Way back, the trailers are I'm So Fancy, and the distant trailer is Lockdown Lindy. The half was 56-1, just 29-1 in the second quarter as Mission Brief methodically takes the lead. Mission Brief now by two. Early pace setter Wild Honey back in second. Magic Marker on the inside, third. Here comes Sweet Thing on the outside, fourth. She's uncovered as they pass three quarters. She glides fifth on the inside. Getting in gear late is Gatka Hanover to the outside. And then comes Concentration, but it's Mission Brief who strides away in 1:23-4. End of the stretch. Mission Brief by 2.5-3 lengths. Wild Honey on the inside, second. Magic Marker on the outside. It's still Mission Brief in front. Mission Brief, Wild Honey coming to her from the inside, but Mission Brief is wrapped up here and just cruising.
Mission Brief gets away third, but we're all pretty sure she's not going to stay there very long, right? She goes right to the top. Yana Jingra and the Super Freak, they're in control in the front by a couple lengths by the time they get by the three-quarter pole, and that's where they stay. They went in 1:51-4. Wild Honey was second. Magic Marker was third. Dun-da-da-da! The big girl power announcement. We have a filly in this year's Hambletonian, which will take place on August 8th at the Meadowlands, and it's Mission Brief. Yes,
wow.
Ron Burke and the connections of Mission Brief, they decided, you know what? We're going to try to take on the boys this year, and I thought the quote by Ron Burke was really great. He said, we could put her in the Oaks, yeah, mm-hmm. of course, but the Oaks doesn't change lives. Winning the Hambletonian changes lives.
Wow.
So it's like go big or go home. You know what I'm saying? So, you know.
And you know what the thing is, too? Every time a filly races against the boys in the Hambo, it's a big deal. It adds an extra element, which is like, wow, it's great. The filly, it's just unusual.
Oh, yeah, it is. It's unusual. But many fillies have done very good against the boys in the Hambletonian. So this is really exciting. Yeah.
But it's not as unusual as Cyndi Lauper, right?
Oh, she is so unusual.
She's so unusual. Okay. Speaking of Vernon, let's go to the ninth race and the Colts. And here we go in the three-year-old Trotters, $370,000 on the line. And Jimmy Tactor had a four-horse entry. I think he figured he was going to win the race. I mean, I could be wrong. I don't know. Number one, Uncle Lasse, or however Jimmy pronounces it, with Brett Miller. 1A, Cane Paw Hanover, or however Jimmy pronounces it. 1B, Pinkman, with Yannick Jingrat. And 1C, Whom Shall I Fear, with John Campbell. All went off at 1-9. Number two, Workout Wonder, was 6-1 with Dan Dubay. Number six, Habitat, for the Ron Burke stable, with Brian Sears, was 8-1. And here's the call.
Canepa Hanover to the top here to control the pace. Pinkman back in second now as Canepa Hanover strides out strong. Gap at two lengths now, and Habitat is left in the wake third at this point. Uncle Lasse is fourth on the cones. Whom Shall I Fear is parked out fifth and stalled, stride for stride with Wings of Royalty. And then it's Workout Wonder to the outside, followed by Boots and Chains and Royal Deceptor. The half was 56 seconds. On to the far turn, tactical advantage for Canepa Hanover. Pinkman on the inside second. And now Habitat, and Brian Sears asks Habitat for the answer on the outside, and he tries to surge up to challenge. Tracked by Uncle Lasse, just 2.5 from the lead here, fourth on the outside. Pinned in now is Wings of Royalty, fifth. Whom Shall I Fear, sixth on the outside. Workout Wonder is seventh, and they turn for home. Three quarters, 1:23-4, 27-4 in the third quarter. It's Canepa Hanover. And now with room at the rail, here comes Pinkman, Canepa Hanover. Pinkman on the inside, surging late. And Wings of Royalty has trot on the rail. Tactor 1-2 down to the line. Pinkman takes the lead. It's Pinkman, Canepa Hanover, Pinkman, and Yannick Jingra, Pinkman!
To the surprise of almost no one, Pinkman got to the wire first, got a two-hole trip. When it got loose, it was all over but the shouting, and won the race in 1:52 flat, a stakes record. Campa Hanover held on for second, and Workout Wonder finished third. You know, now Yannick Jingra has a decision to make, doesn't he?
Ah, what's he gonna eat for lunch today?
No, is he gonna drive Mission Brief or Pinkman? And Pinkman is kind of a dichotomy of a name because pink usually indicates the feminine gender, and man, that sort of flies in the face of man. Is he gonna choose the filly or the colt with the filly kind of half name?
Oh,
I'm trying to help Yannick out here, that's
all. Oh, goodness gracious, yeah, I don't know. I guess we're gonna find out very soon.
While we're pondering that, let's go to the Meadowlands and check out the New Jersey Classic, and the lovely one sitting to my left has got that for you.
Me too, where is she? Oh, me, no, that's me. Oh my gosh, all right, so yeah, we've got the Anthony Abitello New Jersey Classic, and it's for three-year-old pacers. The person purses $200,000. Number five is Art Speak. He's a 6-5 favorite, last year's Dan Patch champion as a two-year-old. Started off 2015 really with a bang. Last couple of starts, not really been himself, though. But public still loves him. Number four, Delta Winner. Second choice with the ultimate Hall of Famer, John Campbell, in the bike. Number seven is Split the House. Ships down from Canada. He's looking for his third straight win.
Give and go from Art Speak, and the Dan Patch champion is up and after the lead and retakes command. Split the House yields readily for the two-hole in second. Revenge Shark is right there racing in third. Here comes Delta Winner, underway early on the outside. That flushes out Pierce Hanover, so Delta Winner is now fifth, second over. Baddox Hanover is kicked back on the inside in sixth, and third over on the outside is Hurricane Ali. As they move toward the half, and Art Speak leads the way in 55-2. Pierce Hanover on the outside is a length and a half back first over, and Split the House is in the pocket spot racing in third. Delta Winner is second over on the outside, 3.5 lengths from the lead at the midpoint of the far turn. Locked in fifth now is Revenge Shark. Third over on the outside is Hurricane Ali, and Baddox Hanover is kicked back last, where he is the trailer. Art Speak is in control coming to three quarters. Pierce Hanover stuck there first over on the outside. Split the House needs to shake free. 121-4 for three quarters, and Delta Winner kicks off cover with three lengths to make up on the outside. It's Art Speak with an eighth of a mile to go. Split the House pops the pocket trying to come to him. Revenge Shark on the outside third. Art Speak is full out. Here comes Split the House, who's getting up. Revenge Shark gunning for a huge upset. Split the House, Revenge Shark on the outside. It's Split the House.
Split the House and Art Speak both leave out of the gate. Split the House gets to the front first, but of course, Art Speak takes over and gives Split the House a perfect trip. Coming up the lane, Split the House, he ends up passing Art Speak, ends up winning in 148-3 with Randy Waples in the bike. Not too shabby for a horse who didn't even race last year. And this year he already has 7 wins out of 9 starts for the trainer named James Dean. Yes, but everybody calls him Friday. Because maybe that's better than Wednesday or Monday. I don't know.
Friday's a good day.
Friday is really a great
name. Good day for a restaurant,
too. Yeah, absolutely. The second was Revenge Shark, who really was pacing big time. Art Speak did hold on for third.
Okay, let's go now to the Meadows. We have the first of three limbs of the three-year-old open pace. It's a good one. It's the Adios. Number three, National Sealster with Tim Tetrick, was odds on at 1-2 and did not disappoint, grabbing the lead just past the quarter and winning a measured length in 151-1. Number two, Angelo J. Fra, off of 39-1 with Tony Hall, took the belly. Number four, Dream's Beach Boy, an 8-1 shot with Dave Pallone, got third.
Okay, now in the second of the three eliminations, Cooperstown from the Ron Burke stable hit a home run in this race, and it was a nail biter. Coming around the last turn, three horses were battling for that elim win, but it was Cooperstown and Yana Jingra, victorious in 149-4, and they paid, okay, wait for it, $77.40.
Yannick?
Yeah. Lost for words was right there for second. Dooms the man paced home, and he got third.
Okay, Saturday 6th, the third and final Adios Elim. Number six, My Hero Ron, probably named for trainer Ron Burke, was even money with Yannick Jingra and wired the field in 150-3. Number two, Yankee Bounty, off at 5-1 with Corey Callahan, was second. Number four, Trading Up, off at 5-1 with Dave Pallone, got the show dough. By the way, today will be the Adios final, $400,000 on the line for three-year-old pacing colts. Be there or be square. You can watch it here or Pocono or whatever.
Post time's about 4 o'clock.
Yep.
Yeah, about 4 o'clock. Dude's the man, by the way. The horse that finished third in the elim, yep, I just covered. He's the favorite right now, the morning line favorite.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay, that's
going to
do it for this edition of the PA Harness Week. For all of us, Bruce Casella, Charlotte McBride, my boo Heather Vitale, I'm Steve Ross. Reminding you to pick up the pace, just a taste, and get yourself high on harness.
It's only natural.